Good evening, Twitch. How you doing? It's Tuesday night. And I'm ready to hop in the car, because I'm going to be on a bit of a road trip for a while. Going to be taking on what probably might be the most ambitious, and probably also the most difficult, beat the backlog I've ever done for all my years of streaming. I've had long streams before, but this actually might take up the entire month. So, I remember actually last year I was actually worried about Senua Kagura. Estival Versus. That was actually was my one of my main concerns, but now that we've been doing this for quite some time, and I have this goal of beating one RPG a month, I decided, you know what? I was able to get this game on sale thanks to Green Man Gaming at a pretty good discount, and it's actually still on, and it's actually on sale at Green Man Gaming. Not for as much as I was able to get it for, but it's still there at a reasonable price where you don't have to pay the full $50. That's probably actually the most important thing. The base game of this is $50. Hey, how's it going, Garland? Can't stay long? Hey, that's no problem, man. And writing a letter. Very nice. Always adds to a nice personal touch. Especially to the people you care about. But I'm going to be playing through Final Fantasy XV, so what's actually probably going to happen first? First and foremost, let me lay down some of the ground rules here, but first, why don't we jump on to the game? Might take a little while to load. There we go. A Final Fantasy for fans and first-timers. It has been a very long time since anyone's gotten to be able to play a Final Fantasy game. It's been a very long time for me, because if I remember correctly, the last Final Fantasy game I ever played... what was the last Final Fantasy game I ever played? Well, I guess it's not totally... Well, I did play Final Fantasy X for a little bit. An RPG each month. Ambitious. I'd like to think so. How's it going, Zynethmung? I'd like to think it is. But for the first thing, before we start up anything, we're going to go through the most exciting thing about this game. And probably the, just in case, for anyone who's really concerned about getting the game for Windows. Last Final Fantasy I played was 5. You know, you would be actually, you would be right. The last Final Fantasy game I actually did play was 5. I never beat 5, and I beat that last year, actually, I'm forgetting the name of it right now. Someone crucified me. This is terrible. You're right. Final Fantasy 5 was actually the one I actually beat. It's going well. Awesome. You're right, it's Final Fantasy V. That was actually the last one I beat. But before that, I was actually thinking what is the latest Final Fantasy out of the entire franchise. So you're correct. It definitely is Final Fantasy V. It was the last Final Fantasy I actually beat. Because I only got about halfway through Final Fantasy V originally. But the first thing I want to do is basically show people the options. Probably the most important thing is I like to... try and build awareness for consumers and such, and for the few times I do buy games that are released new, I think it's important. So we're going to take a quick look at the options. I did already set up everything to my settings if the stream starts lagging or the game starts slogging down in terms of speed. I will probably change things up first things first. Language. Very straightforward. Lots of different languages you can get for voice acting, and of course lots more for text. Definitely made sure this game is going to appeal to a wide audience. We are going to go with English, so if you don't appreciate English voice acting, you might want to go somewhere else. I actually don't know. It's been a long. I've actually really heard the voice acting of a Final Fantasy game. It's going to be actually kind of new for me, actually hearing the characters. And actually, a Final Fantasy game being fully voice acted. Because the later half, like we're talking about 10, 10, 12, and the 13 series, I never actually played. Like, I dabbled with 10. I played that a little bit, but I didn't even touch, you know, get very far. But the rest of them, didn't touch. 11, I actually did play 11. I tried that for a month, but it was not a solo-friendly game. Combat, it actually allows you to have active, or wait, and of course always allow you to read the default. We'll be going with active, because that was the default. Audio, that's actually one of the options they actually give you in the setup, so when you actually boot up the game, it asks you a few questions. There's two options, television and home theater. I'm going with television, because I can't think of anything else for home theater. Master volume, music, voice. I'm going to leave them all on max right now. Unfortunately, and this is the thing I actually like about some games that actually do this. If you ever select the option and you press left or right, it'll play some sort of sound effect. Like if you listened to Double Dragon Neon, for example. Like if I was moving up and down for a sound effect, it would actually was, I believe it was Double Dragon Neon, it would play a sound. So you'd actually kind of know where the volume is, because I always like having the voices actually be a little higher than the music. But for now, we're just going to leave things as they are. Subtitles. Default is actually off. I'm definitely going to turn them on. Names is actually another thing that's actually a default off. I don't understand what that means, but it says toggle speaker name display. So I'm actually going to leave that on, just kind of see what that's like. Display. Very friendly. It's very limited, but you'll see in a second, though. Full screen, I have that turned off so I can actually see chat, because apparently if you have the game on full screen, it's going to black out your other monitor. So, just as a note, frames per second, actually, you can actually turn that on. So, currently I have 120 frames per second, system memory is taking about almost half of my memory card. And just GPU memory, it's not taking a huge toll on it, but this is a fairly simple display. Graphics. This is actually something I used for the first time I used that GeForce optimizer. So this is the default settings it gave me. If things, these are specific things to NVIDIA. It decided no dynamic hair, no ambient occlusion. So apparently we're going to have realistic grass and soft shadows enabled. Once again though, if things start going slow in terms of frame rate, I'm going to turn it down. I'm going to lower the settings. I'm going to probably set it to its preset high. Brightness. Brightness is brightness. Controls. Probably actually the most interesting part about this. Interesting part about the options here. It's not customizable for a gamepad, but it gives you different types. So if you're very much used to playing, and I was actually scratching my head for a bit as I was actually looking over this and doing prep for this stream. Type A is very much your, I guess you would say, the traditional RPG player if you play Japanese RPGs, because in Japan, if you play PlayStation games, now or most RPGs these days in the States, you would have, if you're looking at, say, a PlayStation controller, for example, you would press square or X on an Xbox controller, and that would be your confirm, and then A or X would be cancel. And that's still true, but for if you're playing, like, a Japanese RPG, it would actually be B. That would actually be your confirm option, and that's actually what type A is. Type B is more, I guess, more traditional. I guess you would call it kind of a Western RPG, where you would have, like, A as your jump, X would be your attack, and we're gonna go with that. And type C was actually kind of interesting. It kind of reminds me of Armored Core-style controls. So, your attack and defend would actually be on your L, I guess these would be L2 and R2, respectively. So it's kind of like a Dark Souls controls. I'm going to try type B. I think after the stream I'll play around with it a little bit. Just kind of figure out which button setup is best for me. Key bindings. Fully key bindable for a keyboard. Very nice and friendly. So they definitely did do their job on that. And even shows for downloadable content as well. Camera, Very straightforward, honestly. Just shows if you want it inverted or normal, depending how you want it. Sensitivity, so how quickly camera goes. Positioning, you can actually have this very far away if you want a very, I guess, cinematic look. Or near if you like things up close and personal. We're going to choose middle for now. Ally cutaways. Toggle cutaway shots on or off when your allies use an item or fall in battle. Interesting. These are the defaults. I'll probably play with them a little bit more after the stream. Minimap. I gotta have a minimap. And it actually allows rotation and such. So if you want the world to circle around you, or if you like a static minimap. Vibration. Very straightforward. I'm going to skip over that. Control the guide. I'm going to leave that on just because it's a control guide for now. Game display, you can actually just simply reduce the... Oops, that's not what I want. You can reduce the display area. HUD, that's very simple, I'm going to leave that on. Stamina bar was actually one that was left off. I don't understand this, just because I never played Final Fantasy XV. Toggle and overhead stamina bar. I'm choosing to leave that on for now just because I want to understand what it does first. So, those are our settings. That's enough of delay. First stream here for this is probably going to be very slow, so let's jump in. Ready for a ride. Select difficulty. We are definitely going to go with normal difficulty. Tutorial offers interactive explanations about the story and combat of Final Fantasy XV. Initiate tutorial before starting the game. I heard there's a car in this game. Are there car settings? There are probably car settings for this, and it'll probably get explained if I actually get to the car in today's stream. Very doubtful, though. So what do you guys say? Should we do the tutorial, or should we do Trial by Fire? I'm leaving that choice up to you. But just to let you know, tutorial offers interactive explanations about the story and combat system of Final Fantasy XV. So, should we leave this on, or turn it, or should we initiate the tutorial before starting the game proper? I love the music already. It's actually pretty nice music. Alright, well, since no one is, I'm actually interested. Let's go tutorials. Sorry, Zynath. You know, I'll admit, I actually do want the story. If you're playing an RPG, I think the story is the most important thing. Aw, oh, it looks like Carbuncle. Huh. It was Carbuncle, that's cool. Cactuar. Here's the old training room in the world of your dreams. I'm gonna teach you the ins and outs of this world to help you along your journey. I already have a friend, and his name is Carbuncle. Welcome to the old, combat tutorials. Let's start fighting. Gladius, this will help you train. What a pal. Alright, let's get started. Combat basics. Defend yourself! Okay, defending! How do I defend? First, let's practice defending. Phase. Hold left button to automatically evade attacks. The key is to defend slightly ahead of time. So if I just... Oh, I have some movement. So all you have to actually do is just hold the button. That's honestly kind of OP. Alright, now it's your turn to strike. Blitz. Hold X to automatically chain attacks. Move left joystick while attacking to change the way the combo unfolds. Strike a foe from behind to deliver a blindside to do 50% more. Hey, how's it going, Chiark? If you know what a carbuncle is. I didn't even know. I thought Carbuncle was just a fantasy creature. If you would like to enlighten us, I'm always interested in more knowledge. Alright. Attack Gladius. Let's just hold down the button. It'll be a little hard to get behind him. Oh, when behind an enemy. Circle behind and whack. That's how you do it. Okay. That's kind of interesting. You literally just hold down the attack button. Ah, parrying. This is going to be interesting. Block. Certain enemies' attacks can be parried when a shield will appear signaling for you to defend. After defending with left button, press swiftly. Okay, so you can hold down the left button, L1. Okay. As long as you're holding down, you can see your stance change. And I gotta say, that is... Not just has some weird-shaped boots. It's not just me, is it? Oh, I tried to attack too soon. I'm surprised the camera doesn't center around the enemy you're attacking. Ooh, look at that artwork. Oh, there's a lot of actually cool artwork. Noctis will take heavy damage if you fail to perform the initial block. Yeah, I kinda noticed that. Intense Drill is available to help you hone your parrying skill. Cool. Is it bad or I prefer this style of gameplay than the old Final Fantasy has done? I feel like this is a very mixed way. Hang on a second, Gladius, I need you to hold still for a second. So there's the world. Kinda need you to not bother me right now, Gladius. Ah, so stamina is just for running. Let's just appreciate the artwork here. Ooh, look at that one. Hey, that looks like... Hey, I guess that's Noctis's dad. Alright, This is kind of weird for the camera and not being centered. Right. And goodbye, Gladius. Now you got the hang of the basics. Say, while you're here, want to practice warping too? Begin the next tutorial, redo current tutorial, like, well, let's do the next tutorial then. Alright, I guess we're doing tutorial time. I actually do like the artwork of Final Fantasy 1 through 6. I actually like both of them. The sprite artwork and the... I guess let's just call it, let's call it... The artistic artwork. Or the style that, many people probably know. Like, I liked it in the instruction booklets. And such, but I don't feel like it mixes well with the most of the games. Warping! Alright, it's warping time. You know, the sad part is just to let you know, on the bottom bar is actually my Windows bar. I can't actually see my health or magic. Blade Warp. Noctis has the ability to instantly warp to where he throws his weapon. Okay. Perform a Blade Warp. Alright. Okay. We literally throw a sword. Press B to hold your sword. Lock on. Oh, so I guess you hold it. Okay, so hold it for lock on. Gotcha. RB plus R to track. When locked onto an enemy, a blade warp becomes a warp strike. Track a target to stay locked on without holding right button. Okay, the camera stays centered on target, helping. Okay. So, lock onto Gladius. Okay, so it's but you have to hold it down. Interesting. Damage Noctis deals increases with distance. Interesting. Warp strike Gladius. Point warp. In addition to warp striking enemies, Noctis can also point warp to specific locations. Look around, press B to warp point to the marker. And point warp to blue markers when they appear on the screen. point warp, warp strike. While suspended from a point warp spot, Noctis will automatically lock onto a target. Interesting. Oh, hold on, and warp strike. Ah. Managing magic power. Warping and phasing consumes magic. A mana bar I can't see because of it being in windowed mode. Good job. Actually, hang on a second. There might be a fix to that. I'm gonna try something. My change, actually, that did not look right. One second. That's not gonna fix it, is it? Let's not do that then. The game also allows you to switch between mouse and gamepad instantaneously. If only platformers had more points. Oh. Noctis uses MP into deficit, he enters stasis, which severely limits his abilities. Keep an eye on MP and use items to keep it replenished. Take cover behind large objects like rocks and pillars to recover both HP and MP. Interesting. Take cover and restore, so you hold down the defense button. Perform a point warp instantly. Performing a point warp instantly restores all your MP. Take note of markers in case you need respite. Okay. That's interesting. Try taking down with Gladius with warp strikes. Oop, that's not what I wanted. Oop. That's not what I wanted either. Come on. Alright, well, let's try and recover. There we go. This is actually a little bit more complex than I thought it would be. The big issue right now is... That's not it. Okay. Alright. Oh, this is kinda weird, honestly. Review resistances. As long as the resist system is not like Final Fantasy VIII's resist system. My issue with the resistance is the... Oh, not resistance, the blinking. Is the blind faith issue. Like, I'm looking at it, but it's not actually targeting. Try striking Gladius a few times, okay? Alright, let's strike him. Good job. He doesn't seem to be feeling it. Weapons. When striking an enemy, the damage value may appear in different colors. Orange indicates increased damage, while purple indicates reduced damage. Okay. Enemies can be resistant or weak to different weapons. Swords do not seem to work very well against Gladios. So you want to try another weapon. Alright. Daggers. Nope. Not daggers. The weird part is, like, I'm holding down the block button, but I'm taking every single hit. I don't know why. Not just obtained a javelin. Try equipping it now. Press start to gear, L and R for category. That's the wrong one. Equip Noctis' friends with weapons, accessories, outfits, and techniques. So he can equip 4 weapons, while his friends can only equip 2. Alright. Let's put Javelin in there, then. Oh, you can even use firearms. Cool. Alright. Interesting. Ooh, this is gonna be a very deep game. I am not... Need to run. Huh. Spells! Use magic, you have to equip it like a weapon. Here's a spell to get you started. This is the thing that sounded interesting to me. Like weapons, spells must be equipped before they can be used in combat. Cycle to spells and equip fire. Okay. Let's just take off daggers. Spells of fire. Okay. So is everything just done with attacks? Yep, it's done straight just like attacking. Interesting. Select the fire spell and cast it on Gladius. Okay, there we go. Look at all these emojis. Pretty cool in a don't burn me alive, please sort of way. Prime spell. The magic is extremely powerful and destroys indiscriminately. Take care that your allies are not caught in the devastation. Awesome. There's friendly fire. Enemies can be resistant or weak to different elements. Gladius is currently weak against fire. When a weakness is struck, damage of values appear in orange. Okay. Noctis cannot warp strike while wielding a spell or machinery. Let's just first switch to another type of weapon. Ooh, that's gonna be interesting. Wonder if there's leveling up weapons and checking resistances. This game features two combat modes, active and wait. Wait mode emphasizes strategic elements of combat. Engage wait mode and lock onto an enemy to analyze it. Okay, here's some elemental energy you can use to craft spells. Ice energy. Same old tricks won't work against on Gladio this time. Find out what he's weak to, and then let him have it. Okay. Oh, so if it's active combat, do you... Nope. Okay, so... Adjust the amount of energy to add to a catalyst when crafting to increase the spell's potency or add an effect. Okay, so I guess this is the... I guess Blizzard? Okay. No, that's not it. Hang on a second. How do? Discard guide history. Oh wait, do I have to... Hang on. So fire. I must empty the flask with sprint before I can use it. Okay, so... Oh! Wait a minute, then that... I'm not understanding this. This part I'm not understanding. Do I have to unequip it? I have to unequip it. Hang on. So... It's somewhat of a weird concept to me, as well. Do I just have to keep going or something? This is the part that's confusing me here, honestly. Blizzard, thunder, and wild magic. Like, the reason why this is oh wait, I think I have an idea. I just disposed all of my fire. Yeah, this part of the tutorial is not that great, honestly. Well, I just destroyed all of my magic. Did I actually get rid of all my magic? I think I did. Yes, I did. I actually threw away all my fire magic. Like, I'm not understanding this because there's no confirm option. More energy means more potency. Raising potency above 100 produces a higher tier spell. Click on empty flask and see how much of the spell you want. I usually go all in, go down, and click the craft. There's no craft button, though. Oh, I see it now. Okay. Oh, duh. I don't know why you would literally... Okay, fine, whatever. Alright. So I have 3 Blizzard, then. Alright. So, let's actually do one other thing, then. So they want me to change it to wait for a second. So combat, wait. And says... No, that's not it. This... Libra, oh, okay. So he's weak against... So he's strong against javelins, weak against daggers, weak against ice. Oh, that's actually kind of cool. Why only have that in the wait time, though? Let's actually hang on a second. I'm curious then. Because that's only available in the wait. Hang on a second. I have to. No, it would have to work. It would have to work. Oh, I have to wait and recharge, and since I don't have daggers, kinda makes the point moot. I'm not using this weakness. I understand the gameplay perspective, just inside the world doesn't make any sense. Teamwork, okay. Yeah, no, I think it's one of those things you kind of get used to in time.
You rang?
Link strikes, okay. Noctis' friends engage in combat automatically. If they're nearby when Noctis performs a parry or blindside using a sword, greatsword, or polearm, they may join in for a link strike. Interesting. Okay. Assuming I can actually get a parry. So it had to be... Okay. Interesting. Noctis' friends have unique techniques they perform at his command. Performing a technique completes the tech bar, which fills gradually in battle. Try having Prompto perform Piercer. Okay. Really weird, actually, only... Okay. Okay, what do I gotta do here for you? Oh, right trigger, whoops. Oh, this, okay, I see. Alright. A follow-up, a successful technique creates an opening for Noctis. Press X when prompted to follow up with another attack. Yeah, I think part of it is just getting used to the controls. Like, this is really a lot more convoluted than I thought it would be. Kind of reminds me of, like, Monster Hunter. Spend AP in the Ascension menu to learn new techniques and put the myriad to effect cease in battle. Okay. Danger. Oh, lovely. Thank you for the strike. Well, at least they'll teach me something. When Noctis runs out of HP, he enters a state of danger. This not only impairs his abilities, it also decreases his maximum HP over time and when he takes damage. When his maximum HP falls to 0, the game is over. Okay, so you bleed out just kind of like you would in, PlayerUnknown's, Borderlands, and many other games. Not just recovers from danger within time or when a friend comes to his rescue. Okay. I need to rely on your allies to help you. Friends also fall in a state of danger when they run out of HP. Unlike Noctis, however, they do not automatically recover and need to be rescued first. Okay. And I can just recover HP faster by holding down the guard block button. Recovering from danger does not restore maximum HP. Okay. Combat items. Characters can still use items while in danger if an item targets only one person, select two. That's why I use elixirs to restore Noctis' and Prompto's max HP. Okay. Elixir. Prompto.
Okay.
Elixir and Noctis. Okay, so elixirs actually have a purpose then. I think it could be helped if he equipped a wand and you would infuse it with a certain school of magic. I think it honestly just tries to streamline the entire experience, though. Potions elixirs lift a state of danger while restoring HP. Okay. That's actually good, so you don't actually have to rely on the AI, then. Now team with Prompto and take down Gladios. Magic Flask. Let's try this for a second. Okay. Okay, that's actually kind of cool. With your buddies at your side, you've got nothing to be afraid of. Begin a new game? Actually, I'm curious about one thing. I want to see what the lore guide says for a second. Take a closer look at the paintings on the walls to learn about the lore of Eos. Time for edumacation, people. Let's have a geography lesson. I have something to say about that just in 1 second. The Lands of Eos 1. Our story takes place in the Lands of Eos. At present, the world is divided between two warring states. Controlling a majority of the world's lands is the military mighty Niflheim, an aggressively expanding imperial war machine. The Kingdom of Lucis continues to resist the Empire's advance with magic. The crown city of Insomnia stands proud as the kingdom's last bastion, but the Empire has already made inroads on the outlying territories, including the primary regions of Lidae, Dissay, and Blinge? Apologies for the mispronunciations of all these nations. After all, it is a work of fiction, and hopefully they'll actually physically say what it is. Interesting. The Six and the Oracle. Old tales tell of six gods who have stood over, watch over Eos since antiquity. It is said they now slumber, conserving their strength, waiting to awaken upon the coming of a plague known as the Star Scourge. She, most of pure faith, is the Oracle, a daughter in the line of those said to commune with the Six. Blessed by the astral gods, she calls forth the power of Eos to heal those who are suffering and afflicted. Her devotion to helping all those in need has inspired reverence for her among people from all over the world. It's actually really cool artwork. Take a look here. The Magic of the Lucy. Or Lucy? Lucy? I'm gonna go with Lucy for now. The crystal is the divine cornerstone of the Kingdom of Lucis. The stone has a will of its own, and channels its sacred power through the ring of the Lucy to the monarch who bears it. Monarchs in the line of Lucis have the innate ability to conjure magical weapons. A handful of close attendants are also afforded access to the selfsame power. A magical barrier known as the Wall has long kept the Empire at bay, and thereby maintained peace, yet not entirely without struggle. Sustaining the Wall imposes an immense physical burden upon the King, and to let it fall for even a moment would invite total annihilation. Oof. Daemons and Night. Eos is plagued by hordes of daemons, vicious nocturnal creatures of various forms that strike fear into the hearts of even the most seasoned hunters. Daemons are denizens of the night, and the more predatory among them are drawn to the roads after dark. People now dread the setting sun for fear of what monsters might be lurking in the shadows. In recent years, the daemons have grown in number while the nights have grown longer. The correlation between the two phenomena is yet unproven, but scientists persist in their search for a link. Noctis, what do you have in there? Actually, hang on a second. That's something actually we haven't done. Noctis. Noctis. Get in view, buddy. Thank you, Noctis. I gotta say, this is honestly kind of weird for Final Fantasy. Alright. Like, there's even time. Talk to you, Carbuncle. Buddy. Carbuncle. There we go. Let's close the lore guy. Let's start a practice drills. I'm guessing those are all... Okay, yeah, pairing combat and combat. That's fine. I think the thing with the system like this is... When you try and streamline it, you can streamline a lot of things, but it just depends on how complex or how simple you make your actual core gameplay. Like, the core gameplay of this is actually kind of complicated, which kind of explains why more... Which I'll be saying, like, they tried to streamline it. Instead of making it convoluted, like having to equip a wand and then being able to access spells, it's like, no, here's just the magic. Here's the magic. Just cast it. So I think they've done a great job, like, it honestly looks like they did a great job just trying to streamline everything, just to attack. That's really honestly the only button, is the attack button. It kind of reminds me, right now, and this is, I haven't played Kingdom Hearts, but I'm going to take a stab at this. If you probably played Kingdom Hearts, this honestly seems to be like your bread and butter right here. And honestly, this kind of reminds me of a mix between, here's the gameplay you might have enjoyed from Secret of Mana, which is real-time combat, but you're still selecting commands as if you were playing a Final Fantasy game. You were still doing like a turn-based thing. Like, Kingdom Hearts still has like, you select magic, you select attack, you select your items and such. And that's what kind of reminds me of. Instead of though pressing the pause button and stuff, there's a button for everything. And let's start a new game. Let's leave the training room. That's the tutorial ending time for the main game. Cool. Drills are also available for honing skills such as parrying and spellcasting. I'll probably do that after this stream. When you're in trouble, I'll fly to your side. Take care now, and safe travels. I'm still curious what a carbuncle really is. Final Fantasy XV, in a time unknown, only a prophecy keeps hope alive in the people's heart. When darkness veils the world, the King of Light shall come. Now four brave warriors begin their journey, prepared to fight. What awaits the four, however, they do not know. Tale of the Chosen King, Savior to the Star. Noctis Lucis Calum. Okay, this isn't good. All right, we're in Dark Souls territory right now.
Hang in there, buddy. Stay down. We'll keep him busy.
Noct, over here. Quickly, before he strikes again.
Here comes. I got your back.
Here you go. Let's go.
The decreed hour is come. Set forth with my blessing, Prince Noctis.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
Take your leave and go in the grace of the gods.
Right.
Well, princes will be princes.
So much for royal protocol.
Not like you had to deliver a formal address.
Your Highness!
What now?
I fear I have left too much unsaid. You place a great burden on those who would bear with you.
You're one to talk.
I ask not that you guide my wayward son, merely that you remain at his side.
Indeed, Your Grace.
We'll see the Prince to Alticia if it's the last thing we see.
Yeah, what he said.
Hate to break this up, but Kor's got the motor running. Drados, he's in your hands.
And another thing. Do mind your manners around your charming bride-to-be.
Your Majesty as well. Try to mind yours around our esteemed guests from Niflheim.
You have no cause for concern.
Nor do you.
Take heed. Once you set forth, you cannot turn back.
You think I would?
I need only know that you are ready to leave home behind.
Don't know about you, but I'm ready as I'll ever be.
Take care on the long road. Wheresoever you should go, the line of Lucis goes with you. Walk tall, my son.
That was actually really touching. Chapter 1, Departure. Prisnoctis Lucis Calum sets forth from his homeland with his three men, retinue in tow. His destination, Alticia, the capital of Accordo, where he will formalize the union of states through his marriage to Lady Luna Freya of the Imperial Province of Tenebrae. Kind of like the mixing Norse mythology in this whole thing. And that is a very interesting thing to learn what a carbuncle is. Not as disgusting as I thought it would be, honestly. Broken down.
I think we can forget about hitching our way there. Thought people were friendly outside the city.
You can only go so far on the kindness of strangers.
You're just gonna have to push her all the way.
I've already pushed myself to the brink of death.
Get up. Come on, car isn't gonna move itself.
Sheesh. I thought the car was supposed to move us.
Wouldn't that be nice?
Can it? Ready, steady.
Push!
Alright, push. 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 Game. Okay. Oh, push, okay. Really? Right trigger is push? I would expect A. Well, let's just enjoy the scenery. And the stream is muted.
Unbelievable.
Not exactly a fairy tale beginning, huh, Prince Noctis?
We let ourselves get carried away.
Look, these things happen.
Let's just hope this isn't some omen.
Gladio, do me a favor.
What?
Push this thing by yourself.
All by myself?
You won't even notice if we just let go.
Prompto, don't even think about it.
Save some breath for pushing.
Ignis, come on, time to switch.
Nah, we just switched back there.
And it's my turn left.
His turn.
My hands are killing me.
You rather I kill you with mine?
Easy there, tough guy.
Any luck?
Only a busy signal.
Hold the phone. Is it just me? Or was it supposed to be way closer?
I assure you, the map is correct. The map said Hammerhead was right there.
Literally, next door.
Looks that way. On a map of the world.
Hang on a second. I want to see what happens. I'm curious. Oh, come on, they have to have some hidden banter if you stop pushing. It's a golden opportunity to throw in an Easter egg right here. Like, doing absolutely nothing. Alright, well, I guess nothing then. That's a shame. Alright, let's get pushing.
The world's a big old place,
filled with wonders.
Tell that to my legs.
You guys even pushing?
Hard as I can.
Sounds about right for a good adventure. That's actually one of the awesome things about Final Fantasy. They all are within their own universes or stories and such. They're not directly connected. Hammerhead Outpost. You know, this actually might be the first... Well, actually, no, it isn't really the first open world game I've played. I played Grand Theft Auto 3, but I guess a more modern day.
Hey there, y'all kept a girl waiting. Now, which one's the prince? Aha! Hello, Your Highness. Congrats on your wedding.
Not hitch just yet.
Lady Lunafreya's groom-to-be, here in Hammerhead.
Apologies for taking so long.
You best save your apologies for Pawpaw.
Well, that makes you...
Cindy. Sid's grease monkey granddaughter.
Roll her in while I'm still young. Didn't your daddy tell you? She's a custom classic, not some beat-up old clunker. It's... Prince Noctis.
Yeah.
Prince. Like they took your old man and kicked the dignity out of him.
What?
You got a long way to go, son. And that slackjaw's getting you nowhere fast. She's gonna take a while. Y'all get her in and run along.
Y'all heard him. Let's get moving. Right this way.
Guess we're pushing this car. Nope,
well,
thankfully not.
They're the waiting game.
Never liked that game.
Never any good at it either.
Alright. So, move. Can I talk to people? Okay, so I guess I can only... Oh, I guess I can talk to her. I wonder. I'm curious.
Oh, hey there, Prince!
All
y'all
right.
Ain't never been out this way before, have you? Go on, have a look around. This'll make sure y'all don't get lost.
Visit the local tipster to gather information.
Well, might as well make good use of the extra time.
Restaurant. Speak to tipsters to learn about the area and update the map. Okay.
Whoa! They got Ebony out here! Oh, Ignis is gonna flip. Wait, what's a kill?
He'll take his time, but he'll get her done. Russian Pawpaw won't do you no good.
So, change view? Oh, cool, this is a first-person view.
He'll take his time, but he'll get her done.
Wow, it actually looks really different than the movie cinemas. Or the in-game cinematics. Can I literally just talk to anyone?
You can't beat the outlook at Lestal. That's all well and good, but first we need to get there. It ain't exactly up the road.
The sprint. That's the weird part, is sprint is actually connected to your attack.
Gas check. We're good to go.
Think we'll make it before night?
If we leave now, we might just make it.
Might end just. Not exactly reassuring.
How long can I hold the stamina bar? I like that it's there, like, but it's, I definitely see why its default is turned off. Wait, what's that say? Eatery. Diner, toggle the HUD off and on from the options menu. Wow, Prompto has no HP. Master Zero Friction, the lengthening heavy-duty rust remover.
You've got everything here.
I haven't talked to my own.
I got a feeling our money's no good here, Nacht.
Betcha Ignis came prepared, though. Let's ask him.
Enough for room and board.
Perfect pots and pans for your next camping trip.
Hey, let's see what they've got for sale.
We've already brought everything we need.
Earn gil by completing hunts or selling trinkets you find. Okay. Up, and then here's the food. The one thing. I recommend talking to the tipsters every time you can. They can tell you where some items are, some safe spots are, and other stuff. Okay. I will definitely take that into consideration. Wow, they definitely, he did say we're stocked for everything. Don't even know what, how to make lunch and meat. Treasures or repair. A repair kit is treasure. Auto parts. Memories of Final Fantasy. Really? Listen to the Final Fantasy, Fort, wow, really? Huh. Final Fantasy IV soundtrack, listen to the Final Fantasy VIII soundtrack. This color sample book, complete collection of industry grade hues. Oh, I've got to get this. Wow, you can color your car. Is that everything? It is. Okay.
A moment, Nacht. We've expended the last of our funds on the repairs. I suggest we confer with Cindy.
Broken down and flat broke.
Adding insult to injury.
Old man's in for both after charging us that much.
Prince Noctis and his royal, I'm sorry, I actually don't know. That's actually the first time I've ever come across this word. I'm actually surprised. And apparently expand my vocabulary again. Retinue set out to set sail for the neighboring land of Accordo, where the princess to wed is betrothed. Having channeled all their funds into repairs for their regalia, however, the four friends must have find a way to earn some gil, the currency of choice outside Insomnia. Okay. Select. I guess that's it. Okay.
Yeah, let's pay him a visit.
I guess your characters don't move their mouths. So, well, since we're here. Interested in an inspection? Holler down to Hammerhead. We pride ourselves on attention to detail. No job is too small. Well, I guess first things first, then. What's the tipsters then? I guess this is a tipster, or is this just... Oh, that's refuel. Okay. So our tips.
Go check it out?
What is it?
She's always so eager. I thought she might have been interested.
Yeah, in your car she is.
Yep. Who was I kidding?
This is honestly kind of jarring to see a realistic Final Fantasy game. I mean, like, more, I guess more of a modern day setting.
Welcome. What do y'all want to know?
Nearby havens have been marked on your map. That's a big map. Nearby parking spots have been marked on your map. New outposts have been marked on your map. Procurement points have been marked on your map. Is this one of those games where you're also gaining experience by collecting materials and such?
But of course.
Okay. Well, I don't have any money, of course. Restaurant proprietors will tip you off to hunts that award Gil and any of the prizes. Slay the targets and report back to these tipsters to claim your bounty. Complete hunts to earn stars to increase your hunter rank. The more challenging hunts will become available to hunt to higher ranks.
Want
to
help out with some varmints?
Alright. I don't even know what level I am, but sure, let's take this then. Currently active, 0 out of 10.
Okay. Appreciate it.
So can I only have... Okay, so you can have multiple that are active. Okay. Well, let's just accept them all then.
Much obliged.
Only tells me I'm going to be heading here multiple times. Active all times, daytime. Okay. And something tells me I need the money anyway.
Appreciate it.
I would expect maybe the first, I don't know, 2-3 hours of the game to kind of be focused on more basic tutorial stuff.
Another day to Golden. Wanna push on? You'd rather take a shower. And you probably should. Let's spend the night.
So if I do. Okay, so I don't have to actually hold it. I can just press it and it'll auto toggle. Okay. That is handy. That is very handy. Ooh. There's chocobos. This guy apparently sells weapons?
Take a look at our wares.
Broadsword, two-hand sword. Oh, they even have sprites of all the characters. That's actually kind of interesting. Kind of remind me of Final Fantasy VI style sprites. So, I guess so. Ignis gets daggers. He gets firearms. So they can only equip two. If your allies can only equip two weapons, I'm curious about something then. So what can each character equip? Equip Noctis and his friends' weapons, accessories, outfits, and techniques. Noctis can equip up to four weapons, while his friends only equip two. Okay. So what? And else can he equip? Shields and spells. Is there? Okay, that just takes care of everything else. He could equip apparently pole arms and wait a minute. Why do I get like these super powerful weapons? That's kind of a head scratcher there. I will say one thing, I'm not a huge fan of for a lot of games that they'll give you like this super powerful weapon. Not so much like if it's meant for storyline purposes, but I just mean in... So, if you play a lot of, I guess, more modern RPGs, they'll usually, like, sell you a weapons pack that'll give you, like, a bunch of items. Like, was it, Agarest of War actually had this. And it was actually turned me off from playing that RPG. It was a tactical RPG. It came with all this DLC, and I was confused if I actually, if it wants to, like, it just asks me to activate, I'm like, oh, okay, sure. And it unlocked all these godly weapons that, from what I understand, were basically end-game content items. Mass Immune is apparently a greatsword. Interesting. Cable, Mage Masters, or Daggers. Wow, really well-known items for the Final Fantasy series. No one has shields, apparently, and no machinery or Royal Arms, okay. Interesting. So what can our guy equip as he equips machinery and spells as his secondary? Interesting. So I guess... Yeah, so if anything, it would be swords for Noctis then. Okay. Timed quests. Timed quests are special quests available for a limited time once per day. Earn quest points by completing quests or ranking high, then exchange them for prizes. Quest points are shared across save files, but the items received in exchange of them are not. Interesting. Actuar, active at chapter 3 and onward. Oh, I'm not gonna worry about that then.
What do you reckon chocobos are doing it again?
She ain't gonna be ready for a while. Y'all need something?
Ask for a discount, ask for a loan, ask my friends.
We're strapped for cash. Any way we could earn a little?
Oh, now I get it. This must be what Papa meant when he said he was gonna teach them boys a lesson. Told me he ought to have y'all take care of some ornery varmints that have been causing a ruckus around here. I'd be happy to pay y'all for your services if you're up to the challenge. How about it?
Old man's got his eye on you, Noct. Show him what you got.
Earn 10-8 action points. Or ability points, apparently. Spend ability points to power up Noctis and his friends. Acquire new abilities on the Astral Sphere from the Ascension menu. Okay. Use ability points to activate the nodes on the Astral Sphere and acquire new abilities to aid you on your journey. Earn AP by leveling up, completing quests, and strategic ops, or by impressing friends in conversations. I think you got a weapons pack of some sort, because you didn't get those weapons when I played this game. I don't plan on using it if it's not meant for... It's basically just trying to overpower you. I really don't like that in a lot of games. I understand it. I think it actually is nice for, say, your second or third time playthrough. But basically, like, once you've beaten the game, I assume a lot of extra content comes with this because it's the Windows edition, and the game's been out for over a year already. Alright. So, combat, Noctis. Air step. Use left and X to take a step in midair after attacking with a sword or pole arm, one time only. Reduce MP cost of phasing. Oh, can I actually see what the others look like? Further reduce MP cost of phasing. Increase Noctis MP by the number of levels he has gained. The effects of similar abilities do not stack. That is a lot of AP that costs. Warp strike damage, so that's warp striking. I'm guessing these are his. Yeah, that's Prompto's. Is there right to zoom? Oh, okay. Okay, that's as far as it zooms out, apparently. Guessing this is. Yep. Gladiolus. Oh no, there's actually some Phrygnus, apparently. Techniques. Oh no, there's trees in general for everyone. Okay. So, is it only three trees or is it four? Techniques, recovery, how many actually exist? Magic, that's... Okay, so magic's as far as that goes. And this is as fast as it go, guys. I wish it could go faster. Combat, teamwork, analysis, hello. Automatically scan must at the onset of battle. That I probably will actually get as my first thing. Stats in Nexus that enhance basic parameters for independent behaviors. Equip two accessories. Ooh. Health level. Increase HP of each party members by twice the number of levels gained. That's also actually really good. Stats and exploration. Ooh. Gain AP for long trips by Chocobo. That's super expensive. This one says, take photos in battle. If 5 can be saved, depletes tech bar by 1. From what I understand, actually taking photos means something. You can hit the left button or right button to make it go faster. That... Oh. Thank you, Shyark. I'm a dummy. Wait mode. Nexus that facilitates combat in time-stopping wait mode. Activate these nodes to improve your tactical performance. During wait mode... Okay, so if you actually like playing in wake mode, there's a special tree for you. That's actually really cool. And enemies even faster when using Libra. Well, I guess for now, let's do analyze. I want that. Lancet. If Ignis can analyze opponents, that'll actually be useful. There's Link. I don't think I have anything else I could actually use. 6, 16, 8, 48. I love how this music is all... This music is a remix of, there's probably going to be hearing a lot of remixes. And just let me know if you think the music needs to be louder or needs to be softer, if the voice acting needs to be higher, or I could just increase the audio just in general as well. I would greatly appreciate that. Scanning is faster when using Libra. Oh, that's wake mode. Never mind. I'm not going to be investing anything in wait mode then, if I have to actually do things. That's way too expensive. Yep, that actually looks like that's all we got. Okay. So I'm actually curious about something. Use the map to locate outposts and other points of interest. Areas you visit and objects you encounter are automatically added to the map. Talk to tipsters and restaurants to learn about the surrounding area. So, how big is this world? Or at least chapter, I guess. Because it seems like this game is divided into chapters. That's... oof. Insomnia. And that's where we drove to. It's the blockade. That's the parking spot. Another blockade. Another blockade. There's a lot of blockades. Alrighty. So, quests. Quests, list of all undertaken quests. Pauper Prince, level 1. I guess I am level 1. Yeah, I'm level 1. Wow. Gear. That's equipment. So, wait. Okay, so you only have accessories then. Interesting. Prince Fatigues. No jacket. Oh! Oh, you have a tire! Okay. I was curious about that. No, that definitely doesn't work for you, buddy. Trendy outfit. Just to let you know, the, if you do have this game on Steam, it actually, you can download it from the Steam Workshop, Gordon Freeman's outfit. Or Noctis. Royal Raiment. Stripes actually work well on him. No. The cucaracha, the cucaracha. A special suit recovered and repurposed by Cid uses Magitek energy to generate a barrier that wards the wearer from harm. Okay, that's actually pretty cool. I'm glad they didn't lose that. So for now, let's actually go for that. Sorry, we're doing this. Oh, it literally is a Magitek outfit for everyone. Okay. Casual outfit. Crown's guard. I was about to say, it's like, you got something against shirts there, Gladio? A jacket, casual outfit. No, that does not work for him. Those are really interesting exosuits. Don't worry, you play this game, so I give tips. As long as you don't, no. Oh, just for the stream. I'm trying to actually find a decent... you really don't have... We gotta find that guy, Prompto. Better outfit. How much time do I got? Alright. I'll promise you this. I want to at least do the first couple of quests, actually looking normal, and then I'll do the festival ensemble. Because chances are we're probably going a little bit longer than normal.
Don't go running around after dark. The demons are liable to rip y'all to shreds. Here, this ought to be enough for a place to stay. Just between us, though. Don't tell Papa.
I am a sucker for, I gotta tell you, I am a sucker for southern accents. I don't know why. It's terrible. But I am. Oh dear god. Oh, actually here, Shark, you would actually be very helpful. Or sure, once you be, you would be very helpful in this. Any of these, did you start with like nothing? Or do you get all of these at the start? I've got to know, honestly. An experience band, a device that stops experience points from being tallied, preventing the party from leveling up. An interesting item, okay. Advice Noctis accelerates the tech bar replenishment rate, but freezes the armature bar. Okay. I don't know. Do we really treat royalty like royalty, if they were out in the middle of nowhere? I mean, if you met Prince Harry or Prince Charles today, would you really treat them? You started with nothing. You bought the game last year for the Xbox One and had no DLC. Okay. So this has gotta be... this has gotta be all extra stuff they added for the Windows Edition then. A lucky charm which increases the rate of fallen the fallen foes leave behind. Stamina badge. And hang without expending stamina. Well, for now, let's actually just use the basics here. I think for the most part, this playthrough here will just involve using the basics.
It's time. Gladio, come on!
Gotcha.
Alright, so...
Looks like we found our first targets. Ready, Noct?
Threat meter displays when an enemy detects your presence. Okay. Can I analyze? Where's my team? That's my team. Alright, let's see what happens. Taunt your weapons to blitz. Hold X to blitz the enemy with consecutive attacks. Change weapons on the fly and adapt to the flow of combat.
Let's be done with this riffraff.
Excellent work.
Interesting. Well, the royalty in the game seem to have actual power, unlike Prince Harry. True. All hail the Queen. Or God bless the Queen. So how fast is your stamina bar? Toggle the stamina bar on and off from the menu. Okay. It's 12. So how do I
don't know what hit him. Let's do this.
So right trigger. So if I wait, then I can mark them. Interesting. Press LV to roll to dodge, definitely hold to defend against oncoming attacks. Oh, okay, so you can roll. Okay.
Haven't you ever heard? Well, the best offense is a good defense. Let's clean him up quick.
Whoopsie!
Hey, Ignis, instructions!
Okay!
It feels weird knowing I just need to hold down the attack.
Get on with it.
So, where are we headed anyway?
Nowhere until the repairs are done. Then we head for Golden Key.
Then after that, we hop a boat, and before you know it, lover boy's hitched.
Wait for car repairs, then wedding bells in the air. Got it.
You tap the stamina brother again before it runs out. You will cover all your stamina.
Oh. Almost there. Give it your all.
Okay. Noctis can instantly warp. That's telling me about the warp strike. I kind of wish it wasn't just like a hold system.
Sure.
Sorry.
We're on the same page.
I am. Up oh, there you go. Finally, actually got the analyze.
I'm standing. No.
Yep. Get lost. Yes. Find me.
Impressive.
Yep.
Nice. Mission complete.
Who could this be? Hello?
Hey, it's Cindy. How goes the hunting?
Actually, we just finished.
That's great, because I got one more hunt for y'all. Only this time, it's for a person. Fella named Dave went off, and we ain't heard from him since. Reckon he staked out a spot in an old shack nearby.
Old shack? Oh, got it. We'll take a look.
Have a good night, Zyneth. Or is it Xenathmon?
So, what did Cindy say?
Needs us to find some Dave guy.
He went missing?
Not missing. Said he's holed up in that shack.
Like, the combat is still definitely something you gotta get used to. I think, if anything, I'll probably play with the controller configuration, see which actually fits. Because it really feels weird having to do the triggers to do, like, the combo attacks and such.
What's this?
Mutant dual horn sighting, codename Bloodhorn. Characteristics, red tusks. Extremely violent. Outstanding bounty on saber tusks in the area.
Knocked! Get out of here! You okay?
We are now.
Spoke too soon. I'm going on.
Okay.
Just don't get too curious.
You'll want to talk.
Oh, you need actually need a button mash. Never mind. Okay, this is the part I'm confused about. Like, I'm holding it down the attack.
Nice work, Gladio.
Yeah, please, just take care of those.
Brilliant.
Like,
no big deal.
Hey, what about the shack over there?
The combat is really is convoluted right now. Because to use your tech and such, they want you to press the triggers. And they make everything hold. Everything to me in this game really seems like it should be pressing the button. Like, press the button to defend and such. Like, it shouldn't have to hold. Warp to the windmill. Okay. How much do you want to bet it screws up?
Huh. What are we looking at?
This creature is known as a saber tusk.
Grunts propose strategies to gain an advantage in combat. Follow the strategies to earn AP. Blue indicates points you can warp instantaneously. Locate the blue marker on the windmill and point at it. Okay.
It skewers prey with its tusks, extracting game from the safety and comfort of burrows.
That's a bit heartless.
Yeah. Don't think we'll be befriending any.
And of course.
Should be good practice.
That's what I'm afraid of, honestly, to this game. It does not. It doesn't have a good indicator if you're actually going to be locked on to this. To where you're going to be jumping to or blinking to. It doesn't say its range, it doesn't actually have a definite lock on feature, and those are things that are a detriment to this game. And it's going to be a detriment to this game all throughout. Alright, I have to actually do this. I have to now hold, just so I'm actually constantly guarding. But, and that's the weird part, having to do that. And I don't know why that didn't work.
Don't die on me.
Hang on, I'll do what you want. Eventually. That's the dumb part of this game, is it has a terrible... I'm pressing where it says I can warp, and it's not working.
Biggie, look out.
Affirmative.
Noctis will quickly recover HP and MP while hanging from high ground. Warp a distance strike, you have to hold the button. Okay.
This one's just for you.
There we go.
Hey, who's out there?
Well, and look who's in here. The man of the hour. Dave, right? Been looking for you.
Didn't mean to cause y'all any trouble. I've been stuck here on account of my sprained ankle. Yeah, something funny about them varmints. I gave them hell, but couldn't finish the job. Still one mean mutt about. Well, y'all don't look much hunters, but What do you say? Put that puppy to rest for me?
Sounds too dangerous to be let alone. Tell us where to go.
Well, y'all got guts, that's for sure. Let me tell you where I last saw him.
Always ask your friends.
Risk knocked. You have a royal duty to ensure their safety.
Ignis earned 150 XP.
Huh.
I've been hunting for years, but I ain't never seen dual horns with blood red tusks like those.
Okay. Fossil wood. I guess you can't talk to your allies.
Wonder if the Knights Growing Longer's got anything to do with them showing up out of the blue.
Made Prompto cut out when he was going to do one of my favorite things about this game. Sorry. Don't expect a lot. Remember, this is going to be my first time playing through this game.
It would be wise to rest up before we set out.
A formidable foe awaits. Prepare for this encounter by resting at nearby Haven. Ignis will cook a status-boosting meal for your party. Okay.
In that case, let's find a spot to make camp.
The hunters are really out in full force around here, huh?
So they're the new Crown's Guard or something?
Similar, though technically a civilian outfit.
They've definitely seen a lot more action than we have.
Is it cool that we rock Crown's Guard outfits?
Be worse not to. They made them especially for us.
Even got a sweet insignia on them.
In the Crown's Guard, your attire identifies you. So wear it with pride.
These are custom-made outfits? Alright, let's see what the campaign is like.
Wanna make camp?
Oh. There we go. Camp at Haven to enjoy a status boosting meal and a good rest to tally XP. Alright.
Let's call it a day.
I'll see what I can whip up.
Report card. A Memoriath Heaven. 0 days elapsed. C for finesse. I don't know why you get a report card. Alright, this has Coleman branding on it. You know, Coleman exists in Final Fantasy games. And you were also apparently able to buy groceries. Coleman chairs. A Coleman stove. Coleman tent. Because, you know, when I think Final Fantasy, I think name brand products. That was actually the weird thing about the demo. Or, I guess, benchmarking. Ignis uses ingredients to prepare meals at camp. Acquire new recipes to expand Ignis' cookbook and a variety of bonuses available. Flame roasted toast, HP boost. Okay, so those are free. Crochet Madame. Bird Beast Egg. It's not saying how much. Oh, I guess it is saying how much it'll cost. Okay. HP boost by level 3 increases. Crispy cheese pizza. Enables sprinting without expending stamina. Prevents poison. And let's have a crispy cheese pizza. Time for pizza. Look at that realistic food! Look at it. I have 28 AP. Interesting. Max HP. Okay. Oh, so you camp to gain levels. Okay. Prompto photography. Prompto is documenting the journey in photographs. Review the pictures as he saves and save his best moments. How many can I actually save? Oh, manual snaps, auto snaps. Okay. I'll Save. Sure, let's save that. And we'll save that one.
Well taken.
Well taken. That's not well taken. Well, that. No, that one's actually okay. That's a horrible thing. Thanks, Prompto. Thanks, buddy. You do me right, buddy. And we'll save this one. I guess he's making a scrapbook. Access the pause menu outside of dungeons and combat to save manually. Note that certain quests may prohibit saving.
Like a father to her.
Ever since they got back, Cid's been the only one looking after her.
Rather more than a middling mechanic can handle.
All things considered, I'd say she turned out okay.
Like any girl, you just need to treat her right.
Treat her wrong and Cid'll stuff his wrench where the sun don't shine.
Take care of the car, and it will take care of us.
Yeah, the car.
Huh?
I don't know if we're specifically talking about Cindy anymore on that one. Well, now I have unlimited stamina, so I'm going to use and abuse that. So I guess if you make camp, that's how you increase your level? A bit interesting. I gotta say, the run animations for each of these characters is kind of unique.
Huh?
Really? Alright. Press right button to open the map. Save mutant. Energy deposit? Wait, where? Hang on a second. Zoom. Oh yeah, we definitely did pass it. Food spot. Oh! Yeah, we definitely passed the fire. Are they marked on the minimap? Alright, that reminds me. Ascension. So I have 55 now, huh? So, automatically scan. Sling strike damage. Increases the HP of each party member by twice the number of levels gained. The effect is similar to abilities that do not stack. Up to accessory slots, that actually seems kind of useful. Increase AP gained for making camp. Angler. Take photos in battle. So do you... let's try this then. You learn a new technique. You must equip a technique and use it in combat. Gain a chance of gaining AP through snapshot. Okay. Send status boot from time, gain AP for winning chocobo races, gain AP for long trips on chocobo. So this is definitely a way you can gain AP, and then I guess actually, if anything, I should probably hold on to that then. Hold on to my AP then. Because this seems like a game you want to create a domino effect in your favor. Hang in, increase HP recovery from hanging a warp point. Savior's Fortitude, boosts an ally's defense after taking them out of danger. Rapid regen. Add to attack bar when Noctis lands attack. Interesting. Okay, so it's showing, I guess it's telling like what's a passive and what's an active, I guess. Interesting. I'm guessing these are all Gladios. Yeah, they are. It's health. So the thing that I should probably work on stats and, brief snapshot. Okay. Alright, so... Actually, then, that's not a bad idea, then. Exploration here. Gives him that. So, then I guess go to skills. Noctis and his friends each possess their own unique skills that become more proficient as they gain experience in their respective areas of expertise. Okay. So, this is survival. Potion provider. New recipe. Fresh photographer. Amateur angler. Okay. So... Gear, guess? Oh, technique, okay. Pierce target with a firearm and hit multiple enemies in a line. Reduces enemy defense, depletes tech bar by one. Up to five can be saved. You actually literally just use him to take... Okay, so this is active. Interesting. But that just... Will that actually level up his stuff then? Mark... Okay, I guess just by using it, you level it up. Okay. I'm still curious about, like, how... I guess you stockpile your experience
sometimes
until you
I
camp.
Sometimes I wonder if we'll ever sit inside that beautiful car again.
Sitting most of the day was pretty nice.
Napping was even better.
Food spot. Wow. Yield ingredients for cooking. Item name is shown on the map. Let's just take from nature. That's what we've learned.
Over there! That's it, right?
Huh. That's a dual horn?
Yes, but not your run-of-the-mill breed. We'd best make quick work of it.
Ooh. Well... Oh, dear.
Wait a sec.
What? Scared, big guy?
You ought to be too. Thing's vicious.
Sure. Looks tame to me.
Yeah.
Look out!
Yeah!
Show them who's boss!
Nice one.
It's not over yet.
Ready for round two?
Well, here we are.
Your friends can support use special techniques. Right trigger technique. You're kidding.
Okay.
Okay. Game, I would love for you to let me go back up to that warp point. Dad said something he left in the trunk for me. Sure.
Sounds good.
She'll be waiting at the garage.
Gotcha.
So, who's up next behind the wheel?
Ignis should take it and never let go.
It helps that he can keep four eyes on the dash.
I couldn't even keep one.
Not sure I'd do any better.
Put me in the driver's seat. Good. Because I need the legroom in back.
I gotta say, having jump connected to pickup isn't exactly the best idea.
The color's amazing.
Okay, so experience is there by stockpiles for achieve the regalia. So then if I do this... Alright, so we've done that first quest. Let's actually do this. And because you asked for it, and because we're no longer doing the main quest... There you go. There you go. Oh, we have a chocobo and a moogle riding on top of each other. And I'm wearing a very... I'm wearing a sombrero. Well, at least it's interesting. Let's go actually do this hunt. So I guess if you... How would you... lose your experience then, I guess. I guess if you game over.
It's only so far a man can walk.
Our Crown City upbringing didn't prepare us for this.
Pretend you're walking to the car.
If only they actually thought they were walking to the car. Hang on a second. Oh, where's the quest then? Oh, there we are. Okay, we are heading actually to the right direction then. Alright, at least I don't feel too bad. So then... there's level 5. That's... jump. Daytime. Alright, fine. Darn it around. It's still on the way, but it is technically shorter. Well, they definitely seem to have a decent scale. They're making you feel like you're going across a gigantic world.
Didn't mean to do that.
Please, I only materialized a broadsword without it. You weren't in front of me or behind. Well, you were behind me, but... save manually to supplement autosaves. Interesting. How do you save, then? I guess do this. Oh, the game actually apparently gives you 2 autosaves. That's very interesting. It's very generous, actually. I don't know why it would give you 2 autosaves, but fine.
Feels so sluggish.
Indeed.
Hey, you have unlimited stamina. There's no reason for me to complain about this distance. Thanks to the power of pizza. You know, this actually kind of feels very homey. Alrighty. So. There we are.
Oh. Guys, we got a little problem over here.
Cool. Go take care of it.
Alone? That wasn't part of the deal.
Alright. Well, I guess I can just wait for him to take a picture then. Take a picture, buddy? Wanna take a picture, buddy? Circle behind enemies and attack to blindside them. Successful blindside strikes can lead to chain attacks with your friends. First things first. Take a picture.
Okay.
All right.
Hey, pronto.
Nice. Now it's time to go to town. Give them hell, Mark.
Gladly.
I wish, like, I kind of wish there was a toggle. Oh!
How are we?
Getting by.
And they're rampaging.
Chop chop.
How about this? Agnes!
I can't tell if you're invulnerable. Take those epic snapshots!
Wake up!
Yes, sir!
That's what I call teamwork.
Like, I was expecting to press buttons, not hold them. There we go, an A+. I wonder what time is like. That's that hunt. Then, care of the howling winds of hunger. Then we'll go for that level 7 stuff. Should be no problem. Level 3 is taking on level 7, shouldn't be an issue. Although, I think to answer the personal curiosity question, I think what I will do will be... Let's see... Man, that deposit had all the magic. I really missed out on that. I'm guessing it's also good to camp whenever you can. I'm kind of guessing that as well. I'm curious about the magic. Like, it doesn't look like you even need to level up magic. It's more like you just stockpile it, kind of like the draw system in Final Fantasy VIII, and just level it up. I did not look both ways before crossing the street. That is a terrible thing I just did there.
Jacket.
And that voice acting for a game like this must have taken a lot of time. Alright, so... How do...
It's rude to keep a girl waiting. You better apologize. What is that?
Oh, well...
A live hurricane. That thing's like... Half bird, half storm, half airship.
You realize that's three halves.
Well, it explain its size.
Awesome in every sense.
Well, that's interesting. Well, it's not attacking us, so hang on a second. Alright, it's all going away. Alright, seems fine. This sounds like a bad idea. That was a bad idea.
You're mine. Done in a minute.
Time to spare. Nothing to it.
That was quick. Not the best finesse. Hey, fire energy. So, last one. Oh, already did that. Let's get a last one here. Let's stockpile all this stuff, then I guess we'll go pick up the car.
Really?
Huh? What? Oh, wrong one. Oh well.
Gladio.
Okay, so there are more random encounters then. I was a little worried about that, because I gotta admit, well, I guess kind of like real life.
Watch where you're going.
And Gladio. Okay, so you, if you see it, it's an encounter. Okay, that's actually cool. At least the game runs great. Like, I don't have FPS, I have the FPS unlocked and stuff, so it feels like it runs overall pretty smooth.
Wanna bash some heads in? You know it, I'm in.
Tactical, what's... Okay, that's our items.
Head bashing.
I'm going in.
Deal it.
Without any kind of plan?
Crush the opposition. That's the plan. You're on fire today!
Gladio, do it!
Ha!
Nice work, Gladio.
You.
How do you deal 3,000 damage with that? Actually, I just realized I just answered my own question. I should have equipped magic. I'm guessing those are the Flux-a-tux.
Last thing I need now.
Eyes peeled, mouth closed.
Well, here what? We are.
A dual horn. You're not what I thought you'd be. Quickly, take a snapshot. Okay. It might get us some AP.
You ready?
You know, you might be able to counter if you start preparing
properly. Okay. Oh, it's weak to your javelin, okay. Hey, a dual horn steak.
That's it.
What's what?
I've come up with a new recipe.
I could taste test for you.
Ah, cool. Finding new ingredients in battle can inspire Ignis to dream up new recipes. Interesting. Alright, let's try this then.
Not the time for horseplay!
My hand slipped.
Yields items.
Attack.
Stay down.
Jump us off.
Yeah. The Prince of Pain.
What's this treasure? A giant hairy horn. That's a wonderful treasure. This is what I wanted. Never work.
Everything cool?
No problems here.
Ignis!
My pleasure.
Hey!
Whoa!
I honestly can't tell when I should actually be holding down the block button or not. I really actually can't tell. Like, that's the biggest... That's one of the big issues I'm having with this game. Is... Because everything's just, like, hold... It holds some sort of, like... faith issue. Because I'm holding it, and it's not actually blocking or dodging or doing anything. When the leader runs out of HP, they're in instant danger. Maximum HP falls over time. Okay. So it's max HP that goes to zero. Okay. Just like the tutorial said. Alright. Get me out of here.
To wrap that up more quickly.
Oh, is that 3A rank? Alright. Alright, there you go. Ooh, mining. I'll take one quick stop. Game really wants you to take its time. Oh, there you go. Actually picks up all of them. Alright. We did our quests here. I'm gonna change out his outfit. That's the accessories.
Any plan of attack? Flower egg door? Yes,
all right.
Keep it together.
Interesting.
Grown stronger. Must be thanks to my balanced diet.
And that's major overkill.
Put it in the books. It's history now.
I just want to see what this sign says. What do you say? You are an empty sign. That is wasted potential and shattering all of my hopes and dreams. But yeah, primarily though, I think what I'll do is try and stick to the main story.
Guys,
if we come across a few things.
Cool. Take care of
it. Actually, that is actually really cool. See, I don't understand that. Like, it's...
I'm the worst for wear.
I guess if you're just holding the button. I had a feeling I wouldn't be able to dodge that forever.
Gladio. Allow me.
Nice work, Gladio.
You're out. Stay down.
I wish it kind of also told you what finesse meant. As a way to increase it. How actually long does it take to level up here? Oh, I'm gonna get a lot of levels from this. Okay. Especially once I turn everything in. I should actually go to the restaurant first. Huh? Oh, my food buff wore off. Oh, that's disappointing. That's disappointing. I thought it would go all day. Oh well, I'll probably actually spend my, That feels really weird, actually. The max HP being reduced. Like, it is really reminding me of, PlayerUnknown. Don't hit zero! Or it's game over! Pick up! What's that? I got a feeling there's something there. Oh, what's this? Hello?
Got all those arms and tricks, Torso. Use them.
Damn it.
Whose side are you on?
Sorry.
That is. Oof. That is sluggish.
Nice right there!
All in together now!
How about this? We're on the same page!
Yeah!
Take this!
Man, that is a... You really have to do a quick time event for that.
Alright, we're done here.
So, remember that? I'm sorry, I'm not gonna be able to remember that stamina tip. I've already forgotten it. I don't know what you want me to do here with the stamina. As a way to like keep a way to like infinite stamina. I mean, I guess. At least jumping doesn't reduce stamina. Alright, so let's go to the restaurant, and let's turn in these quests then. This is what you said earlier, also tip for immune stamina, if you press the stamina button again. Well, okay, there is no, just to let you know, in my mind, there is no reference. There is no stamina button. I don't know what the stamina button is.
Come with us, Noct.
Oh, what? The crap? What? Ha? Okay, I guess I did it by accident. Alright, well, what?
Sid's friends, was it? No surprises.
Alright. Hunt complete. I guess you mean L3? What, you mean like double tap it? If you tap the stamina button again just before it runs out, you recover all your stamina. Interesting. There's some money. Do I keep turning them in? Yes, I do.
Y'all did good.
And that's two. Because it just likes taking its time.
Nice work out there.
Iron bangle. Nice.
What can I do you for?
Any more hunts?
These nasties here have been a real pain in the rear.
I just want a jumbo flan. Level 15.
Order away.
Oof, food's expensive. Chili con carne. Nah, we don't need that.
Y'all hungry for info?
Tell me more stuff. Oh, there's actually more stuff. Oh, there's more treasure. Okay.
If y'all liked it, come on back.
These two ladies look almost exactly alike. Actually, I think they do look alike. Yeah, they are the exact same facial models.
After his son's accident, I never imagined the old man would keep the place running.
Me neither. But he did. Now Cindy's all grown up.
Yep, Hammerhead's in good hands.
All Sid needs now is a good grandson-in-law.
Rest overnight or use an item to recover.
I could eat a horse.
Alright, well, let's go turn in our last one then. Oh, what's this? Oracle Ascension Coin. Is that gear? No? Was that gear? Well, first things first. Iron Bangle. Increases maximum HP incrementally. Interesting. Well, I think I know who needs that over anyone else right now. Give that to him.
Sorry about the wait. Ain't she pretty?
She's almost too pretty for the road.
She's back! We should all get a picture with her.
All the more reason to ride with care. Oh, and before I forget, would y'all mind making a little delivery for me?
Always ask your friends.
Ooh, me! I'll do it!
Someone's eager.
Thought you'd say yes. So I already put it in the trunk. There should be a motel on your way to Galden. If y'all wouldn't mind giving that to the owner, that'd be swell.
Grandpa like grandkid.
Now that she's all polished up and ready for the road, would you care to take her for a little test drive, Noct?
Why not? Take her for a spin.
Sure, why not?
And I needn't remind you to exercise caution.
Alright.
Oh, while I gotcha. If y'all want to fix her up before you roll out, let me know.
Service? How does service mean? Regalia can only be serviced when it's dirty or damaged. Customize.
What are y'all after today? What coat do you fancy?
Deep sea ivory, white paint, blue, ooh. Dark rose, burgundy leather seats. Interesting. Oh my god.
I want the wheels.
You can customize everything. What's... That's... I'm guessing the default was metallic silver. Wow, they really actually give you full-on control of how you want to ride. Decals.
Well, here's what I can do for her.
16-bit buddies. Okay. The Cindy Mobile, custom decal set featuring Luce's most talented mechanic, also known as Lucian Men's favorite pinup girl. Little chocobo. Oh, I guess this is actually what I have? Yeah, it is actually what I have. Interesting. The Platinum Leviathan. Ride around in retro style, like every day is Throwback Thursday. No, I'm not gonna be doing that. Terror Battle. That's apparently... I guess that's a card... No, that's the, not a card game. I guess, like, a pinball game. Interesting. I'm gonna...
Be seeing ya!
Think I can actually buy something here. Before we go, we can customize the car.
Have yourselves a good browse.
Alright, so...
Much appreciated.
Interesting. Repair kit. Not compatible with the regalia, but could have some use. Yeah, sure, why not? Hammerhead sticker. Advanced color samples. This is what we've been saving up for. Let's see. Soundtracks. Those are, of course, you gotta have soundtracks here, people. I'll probably come back for that later. And because we're spending all our money, why not? I don't think I need many elixirs right now. Let's buy at least one of each then.
Please come again.
Hopefully the order.
What's what?
I've come up with a new recipe.
Can't wait to try it.
Huh.
Alright, so how much does it cost to color my car? Alright. Have yourself a good night, man.
Thank your lucky stars, because I whipped up something real special.
Let's customize.
What are y'all after today? Well, here's what I can do for her. Go on, pick a color.
Oh, I have to collect ore for it. Oh, that's the shame. I wanted to color the car. Well, I guess that experience bangle actually might be useful after all, then. I could probably find a good color, hopefully. Might do some looking, see how I can actually acquire some of this ore, then. Is that really it? Velvet blue, pastel, vanilla, pure gold, solid orange, copper, racing red, vivid pink, amethyst, onyx. Okay, I'll see if I can actually, find something for this. Guess these are free? Yeah, I guess these are free. A wine red. Couldn't even tell the difference. So, my god, you can barely tell the difference. But then again, it's night. No! I wish it was a default button. Oh, never mind. This is why. Refer to default. There we go. Perfect.
How do you want the wheels? Be seeing ya.
Alright, well, what's the next thing I gotta do here? So there's a rest area, so let's just rest, and then I'm definitely gonna end the stream. I mean, we have enough money. Okay. Rest at havens or outposts to tally up experience and level up. Lodgings and outposts in towns cost money, provide an experience bonus. With better lodgings come greater experience bonuses. Interesting. Hammerhead Caravan. 30 gil to 15.
We could crash right here. Ditto.
Okay. 0 days elapsed. Ignis, there's a stove in this motorhome. And it's probably a Coleman product. That's a lot. That actually is really cool. That's a lot of AP, though. Not as much as I thought I would get. Oh, never mind. You gain AP by levels. Alright, that changes everything, then. Photography, level 2. Remedy Retriever. A new filter, Road Trip. Guess these are all the in combat.
Hey, this one's pretty good.
I know. I dig it too.
Ah, well.
Damn, this is a really good shot.
I made sure I got the regalia's good side.
Yeah, definitely keeping that one. But I think a gladio yet. Let's keep that. I guess you could have as many as you want. So what's... So the manual snips? View photos taken automatically. I kind of wish part of this was, like, done more judiciously. I'm not exactly a huge fan of the, oh, why not? Let's actually... I was looking for one that would actually have Noctis in his in that outfit. Just for you, Shyark. Just for you, buddy. Alright. Unfortunately, the rest don't exactly look so great. Alright. Didn't do it. I guess the action shots take away from the other ones. I think I'll probably change his photography. Probably not worth the, probably not worth it. But, let's actually pause this. This hopefully freezes time and space. So this is going to run off tonight. Tomorrow, we'll go back and we'll actually hit the road this time. And we'll see where it can go. I still have a little bit of an issue with the combat. Probably going to test a few things offline. If I can actually... I'm going to test the whole... was it? Not a Ring of Resistance, the Nixperience band here. Oh, never mind. Okay, so it points from being tallied. So you still gain them, but they just don't tally them. Never mind then. I guess, okay, I understand what that means now, because if they tallying up means the moment you go to sleep, then that changes everything. Oh, like, I kind of wish I need to take a look and see, like, what this, how the stats are explained and such. I think that's the other big thing. There's actually a lot to look at here. I wish I kind of explained it a little bit better. No, never mind. I found it. That's going to be my reading, then. Okay, cool. I'll actually read those icons a little bit later. But, for now, let's actually press pause here, and let's go take a look and see who else is streaming tonight. There's actually two people who are streaming right now. There is Exposure, and he's streaming Killing Floor 2. If you've never played that before, it's... Think of... How to explain Killing Floor, actually. It's effectively a survival game. But it's not Left 4 Dead where you're wandering, or Vermintide where you're wandering from point A to point B. Actually, no, you are doing that. You literally are doing that. Never mind. I guess it just doesn't really have a story mode where you basically kill Zeds, or as Otto is going to crucify me for saying this, the zombies. Let's be honest, there's zombies, but the name they have in the game is Zeds. Really interesting game. You really got to put in a lot of time, though, to get into the depth of what that game actually offers, though. But even if you play it lightly, Killing Floor 2 is a lot of fun. And our other person is Mega G-Wolf. He is our British streamer. He's also a fellow modder Proton John. Looks like he's playing Osiris, New Dawn. I actually don't know anything about that game. But go check both of those guys out. They're really great streamers. Extremely chill. Very entertaining. They're both a lot of fun to go check out. But so far, I think I'm going to have a good time playing through this game. Now that I'm at least a little bit used to the combat. I think tomorrow we'll definitely play around with the magic system. I definitely want to have like one or two magic spells and a couple of weapons. I think what I'll probably end up having is a sword and javelin. Or the sword and spear, basically, as Noctis's combo, and then the rest will actually be spells. So, definitely gonna be a lot of fun. Until then, take care.